following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Currently in the ring at a total combined weight of 536 pounds, representing the Hart Foundation, Jim the Anvil Neidhart and the British Bulldog.
So we've got tag team action here, and again, ladies and gentlemen, Bret Hart on Mad TV next Saturday night. Certainly check your local listings for the Fox affiliate, like Fox 5 in New York, for example.
That's one of them. You know, Sean's been hanging around the Mad TV set, too. I understand he's got a torrid affair going on with Dixie Wexworth.
I did not know that. Get a think.
His partner.
Well, they are not the typical married couple, and I'm sure my fellow Oklahomans are raising an eyebrow or two at that pair.
Well, and Goldust too. Marlena very frolicsome today, and you got to think they may look more at home in Greenwich Village, that big Halloween deal they have. Of course, I don't know how you can actually tell that it's Halloween in New York City. Pretty well every day is Halloween there, but... You know, when they have a spat over the cable bill, JR, I bet the makeup is very interesting.
Might be. Might be, James. This is a very unusual duo, but certainly Goldust and a Patriot have a common denominator in as much as that they both do not appreciate the philosophy of the Hart Foundation.
Well, about the only thing that these four guys share is a continent. Because elsewise, they have no agreements, philosophical, sportsmanlike, or otherwise. The Goldust and the Patriot may be an odd combination, but they're joining together to defend the USA against the Hart Foundation, representing the great country of Canada.
And the British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith, former European champion, starting off with the Patriot. The Patriot goes upstairs, forearm shiver, right across the throat, it looked like, of the British Bulldog. Whoa! Ooh. The Patriot at 6 feet 4, 275, certainly demonstrates great athleticism. There's a headbutt and a standing drop kick.
Can you believe a guy that big springing up that far in the air and kicking that hard that quick?
And Jim the Anvil Neidhart gets that tag from his brother-in-law, the British Bulldog, and the Anvil will try his hand at the Patriot with the arm wringer, and then makes the tag to Goldust. Goldust with a well-placed kick down right to the ribs, follows with the right hand on Jim the Anvil Neidhart. Neidhart educated at UCLA, married Ellie Hart, and Neidhart now living in Calgary.
And so basically, they had to come down here to go to college, and then they went back up north to Canada. That's what you're saying.
Something like that. Goldust with the advantage. Ladies and gentlemen, we got to take a break. We'll be right back. Tag team action continues here on WWF New York. Goldust, sunset flip. Canyon, Bulldog is down. One, two, three. Quickly putting Neidhart out. And there's no way there's going to be a pin here. Bulldog quickly up, and there's a knockdown.
Referee Earl Hebner has had problems during this whole match. These guys have been in and out so much. It's almost like you need an air traffic controller to keep track of them.
The Hart Foundation will be very, very prominent this Monday on Raw from the sold-out Tulsa Convention Center. It'll be broadcast on the USA Network this Monday night. The WWF title on the line, Bret Hart to meet Ken Shamrock for WWF Gold.
And I want your pick, JR, Shamrock or Bret, which one?
Well, I got to think about that a minute. There's a tag. Tag me, hey, ref! The tag was made, and referee Earl Hebner did not see the tag and consequently will not allow it.
And they're mugging Goldust like he's standing in the middle of Central Park. But come on, JR, who's going to win? Best there is or world's most dangerous man?
Well, I'll tell you what, Corny, I think that until somebody proves they can out-wrestle Bret Hart, I'm going with the champion. But Shamrock's submission style will sternly challenge The WWF champion. And that's not the only title match we're going to see Monday night on Raw. What about Owen Hart defending the Intercontinental title against the powerful and the intense Ahmed Johnson?
And Ahmed Johnson feels like he got cheated in the IC tournament, and he's finally gotten his shot to get back in the title picture.
Bulldog pulls Goldust away from the corner. Goldust will see action this Monday on Raw as well, as Goldust will take on Triple H of DX, and no doubt that Shawn Michaels, China, and the insurance man ravishing Rick Rude will be close at hand for Triple H. Ooh, clubbing forearm blow to the mid-back by Jim the Anvil Neidhart, who once won the anvil toss at the Calgary Stampede. Double team. And Goldust, ooh, clothesline, and maybe now the former Intercontinental Champion can make the tag to the Masked Patriot.
Well, this cloudy day may have a gold lining for Goldust now, because he's created an opportunity to tag the Patriot. And if he gets that tag, the Patriot is going to go crazy.
There's yes. The tag. Tag made. The Patriot will knock down on the Bulldog. The Patriot now overpowering the British Bulldog. Neidhart couldn't find anywhere to fall.
Neither one of these guys. Every time Patriot knocks him down, they can hardly get back up. Patriot drags them back to their feet.
Patriot absolutely dominating here. Scoops up the British Bulldog and slams the Bulldog with authority.
Is he going for it? He may be going for the Patriot missile, JR.
The big man from South Carolina.
He got it.
Finds his mark. There's a cover. Should be over. And Neidhart interrupting the count.
Ooh.
Neidhart will pay for that.
Goldust nailed him right in the chops there. Wait, the Uncle Slam.
The Patriot has just... Wait a minute. Neidhart with a flagpole right across the Patriot's head. And the Bulldog now on top. Don't tell me we're going to get a three count here. Well, by hook or crook, the Hart Foundation win this tag team matchup.
The Patriot was jacked by the Union Jack. The Hart Foundation will always figure out some way to come out on top.
Well, this crowd here not very pleased with the antics of the Hart Foundation. Ladies and gentlemen, when we return, the world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock, talks about his huge weekend right here in the Big Apple.